Alright guys, so we're gonna go ahead and move along and install these. Probably wondering what these are. These are door handles right here. We're gonna be switching out the standard, I don't know how to explain it. It's like that textured, you know, cover, I guess. It's not even a cover, it's just a whole handle. It's all textured. So we're getting rid of that. We're gonna go ahead and go with the matched black right there. Should look good. But these we went ahead and picked up from CMO 5.0, our only part supplier for this build when it comes to OEM parts. So CMO 5.0 on Instagram, you can check them out. But yeah, reason I buy from him is because he knows what he's doing and everything he has is quality. It's not, you know, off a flood car or anything like that. It's all brand new stuff directly from Ford Parts. So hit him up on Instagram, check him out. Dude, look at those things. Absolutely beautiful. I can't wait to put these on. All right, let's go ahead and get straight into this install. You can see this little hole here. There's a little grommet that covers it. It's a little, not really even a grommet, it's just a cover. Done a lot of these at the dealership. It's pretty simple. You can see that little, kind of see how the mechanism works here. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna go ahead and back out this little, you can probably see it. I don't know if you can see it too well. See a little hex head right there? You're gonna have to back that out. And when you back that out, you wanna put some pressure on this, like pulling it out wise, and it should slowly start coming out, right? Pretty simple, pretty straightforward. It's really basic. You really can't screw this up. Alright guys, so here's another little quick tip I figured it might help a lot of you guys that are new to this. I've been doing handles and locks and stuff on these F-150s for quite a while. If you accidentally adjust too much and it ends up sliding in, there's this little mechanism here in here that slides in. It'll kick all the way forward. So what you want to do is you get a flathead screwdriver. It's kind of hard to see it from here. But the mechanism itself, all you do is literally you push down behind it and you pull it towards you, and then you're adjusting at the same time. That allows the locking mechanism to stay all the way close to you and not slide all the way back, so you can do what you gotta do in there. You can see a little mechanism right there and this flathead screwdriver on it. Don't freak out if it ends up sliding out of place. You don't need to tear down the doors. All you gotta do is put this behind there and slowly press up, and you'll see that little arm in there. Hopefully you can kind of see it in here. Move all the way forward right there. You kind of see it right there? All you gotta do is just push it down like that and then slide it forward and then adjust at the same time so it locks out of the hole way actually, and allows you to put the handle back on. Alright, so now we're going to lay the handle in that little key groove. You can kind of see it right here. There's a groove. You want to make sure it goes right back into there. And then you're just going to guide it in. This is going to lay in there like that. And as soon as it lays in there like that, you can go ahead and adjust. Alright, and as you tighten this with the little keyway in there, this will actually start pulling itself in like that. And then you just make your final adjustment, make sure it's tight, everything's good, and your handle's working. All good. And just like that, peasant handles are gone. We're gonna go ahead and throw these out and check these bad boys out. Way better.